Hi, in this video I'd like to talk about another rare form of uterine malformation as a result of impairment or defect of the Mullerian duct fusion during your fetal development that's caused this type of uterine malformation. So today's topic is rudimentary horn. So I'm sure you've heard of this if you are having a condition of uterine malformation. So rudimentary horn is simply attached horn to a uniconduit uterus. Now this rudimentary horn can be connecting or non-connecting to the major uterine horn. So if it's connected, so when there's a menses, the menses can exit via the cervix together with the major uterine horn. But if it's a non-connected or non-communicating uterine horn, now this usually will become a problem for these types of patients because there is no exit for the menses in this rudimentary horn. And it will accumulate and will cause severe menses pains and also other complications. So one symptom that we see people with rudimentary horn, especially those with non-communicating rudimentary horn, is intense menses pain. Diagnosis for this condition is that we will need to do a full HSG, which is an X-ray image of your uterus, to identify whether your uterine horn is actually connecting or non-connecting. And we will also do an ultrasound together with this HSG to give us a good idea of what's your condition exactly. A rudimentary horn usually is accompanying your uniconduit uterus, but it is most likely there. 90% of cases, a rudimentary horn is always present. It is rarely not absent. It is almost very rare that there is no rudimentary horn to your uniconduit uterus. And if you don't see it on your HSG, it's simply because it means your rudimentary horn is a non-communicating or non-connecting one. It simply is not shown in the image. So here at Nantai Hospital, our treatment is that we will need to do a unification surgery. Unification surgery simply means that we will need to combine these two, whether it's communicating or non-communicating, together to form a larger and a healthier size of a uterine with the healthy volumes as well. So we do this using 3D laparoscopy and also a hysteroscopy together with intrauterine stent to help with the recovery process. And we will also use a bioadhesion barrier to help with the recovery of your this surgery. So after surgery, after a few months of recovery, patient can then conceive and carry a pregnancy till full term, giving birth to healthy babies as well. So if you know anybody with this condition, if you'd like to find out more information about this treatment, please leave me a comment down below or visit our website for more information.